السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus, the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri Rahmatullahi Alayh.
Lesson number 847. A very emotional lesson that Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus Palanpuri Damat Barakatuhum Aliyah makes mention about when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was returning from the Hajjatul Wada', and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed an ayah. In this ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Al-yawm akmaltu lakum deenakum, that I have completed your religion, your way of life for you. Wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-islam deena, and I have given you Islam as your religion and I have loved this religion for you. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu begins to be emotional and crying. Sahaba asked, oh Abu Bakr, what makes you emotional at this point in time whereby an ayat of the Quran is revealed? He replies that this is indicative of the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After the Hajjatul Wada, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam returns and he comes back to Medina Munawwara. And 9 days before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passes away, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals the last verse of the Holy Quran, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ ثُمَّ تُوَفَّى كُلُّ نَفْسٍ مَّا كَسَبَتْ وَهُمْ لَا يُظْلَمُونَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing us and Allah is telling us, fear the day when you will turn back towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every soul shall be retributed for their doings, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not oppress any individual. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then said that my body is in a lot of pain and I have a very severe headache, but I wish to go and visit the shuhada of Uhud, the martyrs of Uhud. So the sahaba in unison went with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the mountain of Uhud. And as they came there, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for forgiveness for the martyrs of Uhud. And in that he said one statement, Insha'Allahu bikum lahiq. With the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inevitably I will definitely be meeting you. When he returned back to the masjid, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam began to cry. The sahaba asked, why are you crying? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that I'm thinking and I would like to meet my brothers. And in that, obviously the sisters are also made mention about. So Sahaba Ikram radiallahu anhu then inquired, but O Nabi of Allah, are we not perhaps your brothers? So he replied that no, you are my companions, my brothers, and by indication of this, the females and the sisters of this ummah as well, my sisters are those people that will come after me. They did not see me, but they brought Iman on me. Those will be my brothers. So those ladies that brought Iman on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the passing on of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are actually the sisters of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then got all the ladies of the house together. And thereafter Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explained to them that he was having difficulty because of the pain. And he took permission to go to the house of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala an. So each of the consorts of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave permission for this. And thereafter when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was leaving, he was at the house of Maymuna radiallahu ta'ala anha. And as he was leaving because of the difficulty and the pain that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was experiencing, Hazrat Fadl ibn Abbas and Ali radiallahu ta'ala an, they had supported the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and moved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the house of Aisha radiallahu anha. Then there was a little bit of noise in Masjid al-Nabawi. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, that what is the reason for this? And Aisha radiallahu anha says that Sahaba ikram radiallahu an, they've understood your pain, they're realizing your difficulty, they're seeing the fever that you're experiencing, and for that Sahaba are greatly concerned. In this year, it teaches us with regards to the shafqat and the love that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had for his consort and the mother of the believers and the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, if we get a chance, we will try and complete this incident, inshallah, in another sabah. Now let us read, Subhanallahil Azimi wa bihamdi. سبحان الله العظيم وبحمده. جزاك الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى accept. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.